Collective defense is the term we at IronNet use to describe our unique ability to help organizations defend and alert as a group, instead of in silos. It's a complex problem with a lot of seemingly complex answers. Let's break this down a bit. Imagine this is any neighborhood in any suburban setting. Nice houses, nice yards, nice people, a generally nice place to live because, of course it is, this is your neighborhood. You know your neighbors, they know you, everybody gets along, and you generally keep to yourselves. Now imagine this is your house. This is where you carry on your day-to-day, and at the moment, like so many people, this is where you work as well. On Tuesday afternoon, you step into your yard and see a small grass fire. You're easily able to stomp it out, thinking to yourself, no big deal, it's been dry lately, maybe someone was careless with a match. No property damage, no need to call the police or the fire department. I got this. On Thursday, your neighbor sees the same thing and reacts much the same way as you did. They stomp it out, assess for damage, and consider it handled, without needing to notify anybody. Maybe it'll come up at the next block party. Monday comes around, and another neighbor notices another small grass fire. Much like you and your other neighbor, it's handled quickly and easily with a simple stomp. It's a little weird, but there's no property damage, no need to call the police or the fire department, and no need to raise an alarm. On Friday, your neighbor down the street has a significant house fire. House fires get a lot of attention. There are fire trucks, police, and neighbors in the streets, and a local reporter for the news. There was an arsonist in the neighborhood, and while someone may have noticed an anomaly, nobody thought it was important enough to share the information. No property damage on the first three, so why involve anybody else? If we apply this story to the connected world, we just saw a series of small probing attacks to gauge response times, coordination, and alerting before the larger attack. This is how we defend in the electronic world today, in silos. We generally handle our own situations without sharing much unless we absolutely have to. It's what we've always known, and even though we all know it's inefficient, it's what we've always done. With the visibility and insights provided by the Iron Defense platform, coupled with our industry-first real-time threat sharing capabilities, we enable organizations to voluntarily collaborate under what we call IronDome. In this example, we have three separate companies in similar industries all agreeing to share anonymous characteristics about behaviors they've encountered in their enterprise. Inclusion into an Iron Dome allows for further layers of in-depth analysis, as well as correlation of events happening across multiple enterprises, peer insight analysis, weekly insight reports, optional ability to share trends and alerts with the U.S. government, and of course, the real-time visibility into what's happening across not only your enterprise, but also your group of peers. Same general scenario as before, with your neighborhood, your house, and your neighbors. You walk out to your yard on a Tuesday afternoon and notice a small grass fire. No big deal, you think, and you stomp it out. Your neighbors know there was a small fire, but they don't really know exactly where it was, so you let your neighbors know you saw something strange. From that point on, everybody knows to keep their cameras running to record any unusual motion on their properties. One of your neighbors notices a set of footprints where they normally shouldn't be, and adds it to the group knowledge about the previous strange event. Maybe it's important, maybe it isn't, but it's included as another part of a broad picture. On Thursday, another one of your neighbors sees the same type of event and the same uncommon footprints, and adds this information to the neighborhood's collective understanding of what's happening. Two grass fires in a small amount of time. Could be a coincidence, but just in case, let's take some proactive measures. Hey Alexa, turn on my sprinklers. On Monday, there's a third attempted fire, and there's actual video of the activity. A pattern is forming, and the neighborhood has all the information necessary to make the case for external intervention. The fires, the footprints, and the video footage that actually highlighted someone carrying a small gas can and a book of matches. Your neighborhood adds this information to the collective knowledge base and calls the police. With all the evidence on hand, combined with collective testimony, it's relatively easy to identify and capture the arsonist. Collective defense, simplified, in a real-world example. When your organization is thinking about how to counter advanced threats, consider the IronNet difference. Real-time visibility of your enterprise network traffic, both in your data center and in your cloud environments. Advanced, proven analytics, not reliant on signatures or static values, but on the behavior of your network data. Real-time triage capability that leverages the expertise of experienced analysts to improve the performance of less experienced personnel. Real-time collaboration that eliminates the need for antiquated signature development and manual spreadsheet generation. And rapid SOAR integration so your organization can truly start to get in front of the attacks before they cause damage. That's IronNet, and that's collective defense.